Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video I'm going to show you how to make a fire logo reveal using Adobe After Effects. So before starting this tutorial, let's have a look what we're going to create today. This is the animation we're going to make in this video. So to make this video I'm going to use some stock photos. You can download all of the photos from the link in the description. Let's import them in After Effects. Now we need a logo, so I'm going to use this logo. You can use your own logo, drag into the After Effects. Now create a new composition. I'm going with 1920x1080 pixel and 10 second duration. Hit OK. Now drag the logo to the timeline and go to effect and preset and search for fill. So I'm going with white color and change its size to 55. Now let's pre-compose the logo and rename it to logo holder and select move all attribute into the new composition, then hit OK. Now let's create a new solid. And drag this below the logo holder, then pre-compose it, rename it to effect, logo effect, select move all attribute in the new composition, then hit OK. Now select this, go to effect and preset, select this, then go to layer, then select layer style and select bevel and emboss. Before that, select this and go to effect control, search for fractal noise, change this fractal type to turbulent smooth and change contrast to 120 and brightness 6, and then go to transform and uncheck this uniform scaling, then make the height to 1500 and then change complexity to 2. Now back to the first frame and select the offset turbulent, go to the last frame and change it to 1600. Now select this, go to track mat and make it to alpha mat. If you don't find your track mat, then click here to switch between. So select it to alpha mat. Now you can find a metallic logo here. Now select the logo effect, then go to layer styles and select bevel and emboss. From here go to bevel and emboss and select to crystal heart and change the size to 50. Okay, by the way, if you don't want this kind of effect, then you can leave this step. So now go to the project window . Select all of them and right click on your mouse, select pre-compose, then rename it to logo saver and this point I'm going to use a free plugin called saver from video calculate. You can download this plugin from videocalculate.net. I will also put the download link of this plugin in my video description. So now select this, then go to layer and select auto trace, select alpha, and then make sure that you have unchecked this and hit OK. Now you can also again go to auto trace and change this to luminance, then hit OK. Now select this, then go to effect and then go to video copilot and select the saver plugin, and from here go to customize score and select it to layer mask, and from the preset select fire, or you can use any of the preset you want. As I am going to make a fire logo animation, so I am going to use fire. And from the glow intensity I am using 20, okay. Now go to first frame and press S, create a keyframe here, and go to the last frame, sorry, before that make it 120. Now go to the last frame and make it 100. Now select this and then go to end offset, sorry, go to end offset and make it 0, create a keyframe, go to something like this point, 1 second or 2 second forward, and then make it 100%. Go to around 2 second, press U and adjust its timing. Now select all of this keyframe and press F9 to make them easy is, or you can right click and then go to keyframe assistant and make them easy is. Now select this, press Ctrl D to duplicate this. Now press U to open keyframe, go to this point and drag this to here and delete the saver plugin from here. Now press T to open opacity, create a keyframe here and make this opacity to 0. Go to around something like this and make it 100%, and also select this, press T and make the opacity to 0 this point, create a keyframe. Now go to this point and make it 100% again, select all of them and make them easy also. Now go to the project window, select the plain smoke, paste it above all of this and control D hit time. Then go to something like here, drag this to this point and this to this point. Now let's adjust it. Okay, now select all of this, press right click on your mouse and pre-compose, rename it to smoke, select move all attribute into the new comp, hit OK. Now press T, open opacity and make it 30, okay. Now drag this both particle 1 below the smoke and increase its size like this and drag this to this point and change this mode to add. Also drag this particle to below of this and change this mode to add also and adjust its size. Now select both of them and pre-compose it, rename it to particle. Hit OK. Make it to add and go to effect and presets and search for levels and make it something like this. Now let's see a preview. Okay, now I'm going to use another free plugin from Video Copilots and it's called BC Color Vibrance. And change its color to something like fire. Hit OK. Now we don't want the fire effect here, so go to this point and select the vibrance, create a keyframe here, go to something like this point and make it 0. Okay. Now here the particle is something light red color effect and in this point it's like a smoke effect. So let's see the preview. So this is the animation, and if you want to change your logo, you can change your logo anytime. Just go to project window and select logo holder and you can replace your logo from here, and then you just need to go to here and delete your all previous mask from here, and you need to add your new mask by clicking layer and auto trace. So this is how you can make a fire gaming logo animation using Adobe After Effects and using Saver plugin. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure that you like this video and subscribe to my channel. And again, thank you so much for watching. Bye.